Next, we're trying to let's choose the level that we can afford. Let's choose the best level that we can afford. Let's spend all the money and get the most we can. So a consumer can choose a level anywhere on or below, but anywhere on the budget line. And the highest level is the preferred one. So here's our app example. We have a budget line. That's the straight line with three different curves. Line C, whatever curve C, we can't get there. We can't afford it. That's above our budget line. Line A, we can afford it, but it turns out there's a better level that we can get. That's higher up. So bundle B is the best level we can get that we can afford. What's happening now is that's the point where the difference curve is tangent to the constraint. It's tangent because it just grades across all the touches of the points. All points on the lower curve are inferior, all points on the higher curve are preferable. So if we were doing calculus, our point of tangency, if our difference curve was a polynomial function, we would take the derivative, set it equal to the slope. That slope is the ratio of precedence, so we would use calculus to find the point of tangency numerically. Now we're going to do graphic again. That's a nice geographic paper, but that's okay. So in this one, we're going to just draw a line down, we're going to see which one will be picked. But point where that works for the middle of the digit, but it's 2.5 on this axis and something like 1.3 on that axis. The point of tangency is going to reveal the quantities to us. So now we can look at a shift in income, like you guys did earlier on. If we increase the income, it's going to shift the budget line out parallel, the slope will stay the same. Income is only going to go except around, it's not in the slope. So, I know we talked about previously in the first lecture, a normal good is an inferior good. But if it's a normal good, if income increases, the quantity of purchase increases. If it's inferior good, as income increases, the quantity that we consume decreases. So here I tried to make a map of an inferior good using these different terms. Income increases in our budget line has a parallel shift out. But we decide that we want to consume a whole bunch more of good 2 on the x-axis and not consume more of good 1 on the y-axis. So that graphical representation of what shift in increasing income will lead us to consume less of good 1. So we can back out a demand term from here. The consumer is choosing the bundles that maximize the utility in the budget constraint. The budget constraint, general notation, I was talking about before, and the difference curves are going to be mapping their references amongst the bundles. And we can get a demand curve by holding everything else constant. If we vary the price of good 1, holding income and price 2 constant. A lot of things in economics are holding everything else constant, just very little thing. So, go on the slide for a little bit. So, we had this as coffee about us before, we had a good 1, good 2. We're going to hold the price of good 1 constant here, we're changing the price of good 2 for products. And this is what we talked about in the next look for this example. The budget constraint line.